Good morning students, welcome to the Java session. And the last class we discussed about data types in Java, and today we are going to see the variables. What is variable? How variables are declared in Java, and how we will going to initialize the values to the variables. Variables. See, variables are very important concept in any programming language to store the values in the variables, then only that we are going to use in our program. If you want to store any values or information in the variable, first we have to declare the variable in the particular type, then we are going to use the particular values or information in the program. The variable, it can store anything, like it can store digits, letters, then it can store video, audio, any information it can store. So variables are, first before using in the program, first we have to declare and we have to store the information, then only it can be used in our program first. So what is variable? Variable is a container, or it is a placeholder to store the values or information that we are going to use in our program. So what is variable? A variable is a container to store the values that we are going to use later in our program. So the variable, it can going to be declared by using the any particular type. So without data type we cannot declare the variable. So we are going to declare the variable according to the particular type. What type of information we are going to store in the variable, according to that we have to choose the data type along with the variable. So then you can store the particular information in the variable. So the variable can store the data in the following particular data types. There are 8 data types are supported in Java to declare any variable. So that is, you know already, byte, short, int, long, float, double, character and boolean. So these are the 8 primitive data types you are going to use to declare the any variable in the Java. So first, how to declare the variable? Variable declaration. Declaring a variable. So variables can be declared with the data type along with the variable name. So what is the syntax of declaring the variable? Syntax. Data type, variable name, semicolon. So this is the syntax of declaring the any variable in the Java. Data type followed by variable name. Here data type indicates what? Data type means any data type with the primitives, that is byte, short, int, long, float, double, character and boolean. Using any one of the data type you can use the to declare the variable. Then variable name means name of the variable. So the variable we have to choose by following the rules of identifiers. You know the rules of identifiers. According to that we have to give the variable name. So you know how to set the variable names by the rules. Always the variable names, the name should start with the alphabets, and it cannot have any space in between the variable name. Variable name cannot start with number, and cannot use any keywords as variable name. So those are the rules we have to follow to declare the variable name. After giving the name, finally you have to put the semicolon, that is end of the declaration. So now take one example. Example, integer account number. So here integer account number, integer space account number. Account number is a variable name of type what? Int. It is a, it can store the integer values. You know the range of integer values. Integer is having how many bytes? Integer is having 4 bytes. Then it can going to store the values in the particular range. So now here similarly we can also declare the other types. For example, we can also declare byte byte serial number, for example, then short, register number, or short you can give any some number, then long, account number, then float, price, double, total price, then character, ch, then boolean, flag. So like that you can also declare other data types. So these are the some example of declaring the variable. So here declaring variable means what? Just the variable is declared but not assigned, but not assigning any value, the variable just declared. Understood? So once the value is assigned to the variable, then only the memory will be allocated particular variable in the memory. So now it is just declared the variable in the particular type. So now assigning values to the variable. So the values can be assigned to the variable in two ways. The values we can assign either at the time of declaration, or we can assign the values after declaration. So that is the way of assigning the values to the variable. So we can assign the values in two ways. One is we can assign the values at the declaration itself. At the time of declaration itself, we can declare and assign the values to the variable, or first you can declare the variable, later you can assign the values to the variable by using the assignment operator. So what is the syntax of assigning the values to the variable? See syntax. Data type, variable name, value, semicolon. So this is the syntax of assigning the value to the variable name, data type followed by variable name equals value. So this is the assignment operator we are using to assign the values to the variable in the particular type. So now example. Integer a is equal to 10. See, now here I am assigning the value to the variable a 10. So 10 is a value that is assigned to the variable a of type integer. So similarly, float f is equal to 1.2 f. So here a 1.2 is a fractional value that will be assigned to the variable f of type float. So here f indicates float value. Similarly, you can also declare for double d is equal to 24.265 d. So d for double. So like that we can assign the values to the variable at the time of declaration. This is called one type of assigning the value. Or I told another method, you can assign the values after declaration. For example, here integer a, b, c. Now here we can assign a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20, c is equal to 30, like that. So here first I declare the variable a, b, c. of type integer. Now assigning the values to the variables, a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20 and c is equal to 30, finally semicolon. So this is another way of assigning a value to the variable. Or you can also assign in the mixed way. For example, say integer a, b is equal to 20, c, d is equal to 30, like that. Here, so a and c is declared and b and d is declared and initialized. Initialize the values 20 and 30. So like that, we can declare and assign the values to the variables using the assignment operator. We can assign either two ways. We can assign the values at the declaration itself, or you can declare and assign the values to the variable later. So this is the two ways we can assign the values to the variable. Now we'll see one program, an example program, how to declare and assign the values in the Java program. Class variable demo. Public static void main. Integer a comma b c, a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20, c is equal to a plus b. System dot out dot println. Sum is equal to c. So here class name, then class is begin, then main method always start with public static void main. So main method is having the one argument, that is called args, array of type string. Then here we are declaring the three variables a, b, c, and we are assigning values to the a and b with 10 and 20, that will be adding and assigning to the variable c. Finally the result will be displayed, sum is equal to c. Finally sum is equal to, we got output is what, sum is equal to 10 plus 20 30. So this is the output. So like that you can declare and initialize the values in the Java program inside the main method. So thank you. Next topic we will see scope of variables.